Hello friends, today we are going to model an RC frame building in Etabs 2016. So we are taking a new model. So here we can see the different units and different codes available. So we can choose IS code for steel and RCC. Now press OK. So now I am going to take a simple story data. Story is 7 and bottom story is 1.5 and taking grid only. Now we can see here the two windows. One window gives the 3D view and the other window shows the plan of grid. Now I am going to change the grid according to a new model. So I am taking a distance of 4 meter for a new model. So here we can see according to the data entry we see the arrangements we are getting. Similarly, in Y direction, we can choose some more data as it is. So here we can see the grids. Press OK. So finally, we have got the grid according to my requirement. So now I am going to draw beam, column, slab, etc. For that I am going to give material properties. At first I am taking concrete M25 grid. It has a facility of properties described according to the IS codes. So I am not changing any property. In a similar manner, I am going to input the various properties. So here we can see I had input the materials. Now I am going to give section properties, frame section. So we need to select the dimension of the each element. For that I am taking rectangular section. So I am naming it as column. Dimension 450 by 230. So we can even modify the stiffness modifier of analysis. I'm not modifying any properties. We need to here assign the grade of steel and longitudinal bars and confinement bars are given and just changing to a different value and press button OK. So we can see here the column dimensions. Similarly, I am going to define for beams. So you can see the dimension as per I have given. We can see in the figure also similar manner I am going. Here we have to choose the beam design only. Here we have to give the cover as per our design requirement. So we can see here the beam and column already framed. Now I am going to define my slab properties, modify here grade of M25 grade I am choosing and thickness I am choosing 125. Press the button OK. So we can see here the slab also. Now again I am defining the walls as per my requirement. Here I am going to choose shear wall. As my structure is RC frame, but I am giving a lift, so I need to construct a shear wall also. So my shear wall is ready. Press the button OK. OK. Now I need to draw each element in the grid. First I am choosing the column. So here my column dimension is here. We have to change the story to all story. So we can see the all columns in the picture 3D view. Similar manner I am going for beam also. Here we need to put the dimension as per the given condition. So now I have given the beam column. Now I am going to plan story 7 . Now I am seeing the elevation also. Here we can see it is hinge support. We need to fix it. So I am first fixing all the restraints so that we can get the accurate results. Similar manner I am giving all the joint restraints. Here we can see policy. We have to choose all the restraint. Apply for D. Also restraint necessary. Similarly for F also necessary. So now we can see all the columns are restrained. Check it. Okay, now close it. Here one restraint is left. I have to do it. Okay. So we can see the 3D view of restraint. So now my beam column are ready. Now I have to assign a row or column in the grid. For that I had to take a similar story. First of all, I am giving for story 7, so I need not take the story 1 because it is a plinth level. Press button OK. Make sure that you are choosing similar story here also. Now I am going to draw a slab. We can draw from here also. It is the shortcut. Now make sure that here we get the property of slab as per default. So now I am going to put my slab. You can see the as per I am drawing, all the slabs are being drawn in the 3D view also. Okay, now I have already drawn the slab. Now I need to draw a shear wall. So make sure that here the property is shear wall, and also all the stories you have to select. Now I am drawing my shear wall. You all know that a minor mistake can lead to a failure of a structure. So be careful for each and every dimension too. I am selecting 33 meters. So here we can see for all story I have drawn the shear wall. You can see from the bottom of the base I have defined. Now I need to draw a staircase. In order to draw a staircase, we have to divide the column into two parts. You can see that I have already divided the column into two parts. Here I am going to give a dimension of beam column and floating the column. But be careful that here the option should be for one story. You can even draw for similar story by replica option. So I am first drawing for one story, thereafter I will go for replica option. But I need to draw it first. So now I am going to draw a slab from a beam.
So that has been okay. We can see the beams assigned. Now drawing the slab. So my slab is ready. Similar manner, I'm going to draw on the slab at the bottom. Directly the method, just put a negative sign so that we can get the beam in the front side. Similar manner, I am drawing the quick slab. Sorry, we can zoom it out for the better result. So we can see that I have already drawn the landings of the staircase. Now I am going for the stairs. So similar manner, I am breaking the beams into two parts so that I can assign the stair portion also. So here we can see the stair has been drawn. So now I am going for the first floor also. For that I have to select a beam and go for replica. So we can see the beam drawn. Similarly, I am going for my slab is ready. Now I have to break this beam into two parts. Similar process is repeating, so I have not selected, so I have to zoom it out. So that we can get it. So now I have selected. I am pressing the apply button. So we have got the midpoint. Now I am drawing a stair portion. So you can see the drawn stairs. Be careful about selecting all the elements of staircase for the replica for similar stories. Now I am going for 3-4. We can see here already, without applying only, we can see the imaginary staircase. If it is proper, then press apply. So finally I have drawn the staircase also. Now I am going to draw a slab over the lift side, lift portion. For that we need to prepare a cabin type arrangement. So I'm going to add new story. For that I'm going to edit story. Here I can use add story option for keeping existing story height as 2.1 and taking. So we can see the 2.1, hit the story as 2.1. Now I am going to see the eighth story. In the eighth story, I does not require any beam column arrangements or slab arrangement. So I need to delete all the my beam column arrangements. So I am deleting. Make sure that here we can give for one story only. So I am deleting. Here we can see already deleted. Similar manner I am deleting the all the beam column slab arrangements. We have to draw the each element with an accurate . So now I have deleted the all the beam columns level elements. Now I need to give a slab over the shear wall. First I am giving here . So you can see in the 3D we have already given the cabin type arrangements. Similar manner I am giving for staircase too. For the staircase we need to see that the top floor must not have the stairs up to the slab level. So we are deleting all the stairs. Now I am going to define load patterns. Here dead load, live load are default. I am adding other loads. Like earthquake loads, wind loads, so here we need to choose the Indian stone, Indian standards or any standards as per the model requirement. Now I am giving floor finish. also, and terrace also. So if you are working for seismic load, wind load does not play any significant role. Only seismic load plays an important role in an earthquake. So I am not going for wind load. So now I have given the load pattern as dead load, live load, super dead, earthquake, x and y direction, flow finish and terrace. Now I am pressing it as OK button. Now I need to give my load combinations. For that we can refer the IS code. So my first combination is ready. Similar manner we have to go for other load combination also. So my second load combination is ready. Similarly, I am going for the third load combination. So you can see the load combination is being assigned. We have to give for the both direction. As per ₹8,075, your load combination is being assigned. So I have already given the 5 and giving 4 more load combinations. Be careful about each value you are assigning. So we can see here the load combinations, y direction I have assigned, for x direction one more load combination is required. So now I have assigned a new 9 combination and combining it as a combo. Select the row combo 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we can get the combination of load as combo. Press the button OK. So now we got the load combination as per defined. Now I am going for the flow finish and terrace and staircase loading also. So I am going for the live load and the shell. So my live load will be 2 kN. Make sure that you are giving an additional existing loads, and also make sure that you are defining for all stories. So live load 2 kN per meter square, add to existing loads. Okay, so we need to select the object. We can select any one of them as a 3D view or 2D. So now so here we can see the 2 kN per meter square is assigned. In the similar manner, I am going for the staircase only. As per IS codes, I am assigning 3 kN of the staircase. So I have already assigned for 3 kN in the staircase also. Now I am going for floor finish and terrace. Floor finish and terrace. Choosing that load. Floor finish as 2 kN, or we can say it as floor finish 2 kN. Select the object. So we can select the object and press apply button. So we have applied floor finish. Now we need to draw for a one story and the terrace. So now I am going for terrace also. For the only terrace, I have to choose one story only. Assign shell loads as terrace, and here we can take it as 1.5 kN per meter square and press button open. So at the terrace, we have already given the 1.5 kN. So now my whole load calculation and loads are assigned. Now I need to check my model, whether my models are defined is correct or not. We have to wait for some minutes. So Etabs is analyzing, and we have got the message that no warning were generated. So we can go for further analysis. Now I am choosing from here run analysis, or we can go for run analysis from here also. So for run analysis, first we have to save the file. So I am saving my file. Saving my file as RC frame building. RC frame building. Okay. So finally saved, and now my run analysis has already started. So it would take some minutes
to analyze whole building. So my updated analysis is now almost ready. Okay. So here we can see the 3D view reflections as per my results. We can see here the moments, and we can see the reflection also as per my combinations too. I can see my reflection also in the animation portion. We can see the reflections. As undergoing the torsion effect also during the earthquake. Can see. Okay. So that's all, friends, today. Thank you guys.